Yo, I didn't see you there. Yo, I honestly didn't know you guys were coming to my crib, but like, welcome to the crib, eh?
Yeah. Hold up. You see this. You never seen this. You never seen that. Look at this. State of the art. This guy's not a human, he's a robot, right? State of the art. You know that clock right there? Look at this clock. Hold up, let me go zoom in on that. Yeah, hold on. Sir Winston Churchill made that. You don't know that. I do. Watch, hold up. Flick. Hold up, yo. Ain't this a fireplace? Or isn't this the fireplace? Come on now, G. You know what I'm talking about. Hold up, you see this window? Hold up, let me measure. 1 foot. 2 foot. 4 foot. This window's 4 feet. Where have you ever seen this window this big? Now let me show you a little something. Now we're gonna come around here, right? Come in around here. What you know about this? We're bringing it back. Yo, hello. We're live? Yeah. Hey, hey, what's up? It's your boy Jamal coming at you from the palace. You already know I'm about to show you the crib, my sick room, and the toys we got around here. Come on now. You know.
Anything you want to say?
Yo, man, this is my hood, man. Oh, yo, I got money laying around everywhere, yo. Yo, 20, 40, 60, 80. Come on now. What you know about that? Burnaby Boys for Life. It's your boy Jamal on the come up. Come on now. It's a little dark in here. Yo, hold up, man. Get the heck out of my bed, man. Yo. This is my favorite bed, man. Get out of my bed, man. Yo, get out of my bed. Yo, come on. Yo, hurry up, man. I'll help you. Nah, I ain't helping you up, man. Get out of my bed, man. Get out. That's my favorite bed, man. It's my bed, man. Hold up. Yeah, hey, yo, put the camera on this bed, man. Look at that bed. That's my favorite bed. You wanna know why? I can't say why. All right. Now, y'all ain't seen this before. Y'all ain't never seen this before. You know, Tariq, he's a good DJ. But me, they call me DJ Drop Jaw. Yeah.
So you DJ?
Yeah, DJ on the side. You know what this is? Latest edition DJ turntable. I do it all. DJ on the side, photographer on the side. On the side, I also got a girlfriend, and I got one on the side. Yo, chill out, G. Yo, I don't know if you can get this on the camera. Hold up. I got the toolie with me. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, hold up. Yeah. You see that right there? Zoom in on that. You know what logo that is? Boston Bruins. Or maybe the Vancouver Canucks. Who knows? Don't care. Follow me. Hurry up. Hold up, that's the kitchen. Where we kitch. What up, Ron? What up, G? Yo, man, let's go. Yo, you see this guy out here? He's cooking. Yo, hurry up, man. Let's go, my shop. Yo, man, you too much, man. Yo, for real, you actually just gotta get out. Sorry, I'm just trying to get it. Just go, man. Hold up. This is the microwave. Nothing special. Rico, my chef, personal chef. Didn't say he was a good chef. Fridge. And the freezer. Which one you want? I know you want the new freezer. Yeah.
Well, I applied to a bunch of restaurants and they all said my cooking was horrendous, but I thought Jamal was a cool guy and I wanted to cook for him. Luckily he let me in, so that's why I'm here.
Let me take you out to the office, man. Come here. This is the office right here, man. This ain't the TV show, you dig? Take a look at this globe, man. You wanna know where this house located? Pacific Ocean, cause why? Drip, drip, yeah, I got the sauce. Yeah, you know, that's Hoopy son. I got something special for y'all. Bam. Henrik Sedin signed this, right there. Baseball bat, signed by Henrik Sedin. You ain't never seen that. Just a little something. Stevie, what's up, yo? Accountant, look at this, complicated math stuff. I don't even know how he's counting the money. How are you counting the money, man? This is crazy, man. All right, we out of here, bro.
So why did you join the game?
I need money, man. I'm in Vancouver film school, so I'm trying to make a living that way eventually. I need money to pay for tuition and stuff.
Do you view this group as a family? Are you tied closely?
I wouldn't say so. I mean, I'm just here to get paid. You know, I'm trying to be the first person in my family to graduate college, make my mom proud and stuff.
This is like state-of-the-art washroom, right? Like, we rented it and everything. Peep this. Y'all gotta take a good look. Let me take y'all to another part of the house, man. Come here, let's go. Hold up. You see that? State of the art, latest technology. We off to the games room.
What's going on, y'all? About to show y'all the game room and just know, you know what I'm saying? Come on, quit playing with.
Yo, man, I'm winning.
Yo, what the?
Oh my god.
I'm winning, man.
Hey! What y'all doing, man? Get out! Yo, get out! Yo!
Sorry, boss. Sorry,
run,
sorry,
man.
I'm so sorry.
Yo, I expect better from you, man. Get out of here,
sorry,
man.
Sorry.
Y'all playing with my PS3, man? Come on, man. You know that's my favorite controller.
Yo, shit,
too, man.
Yo. My bad.
Gold
yo,
plated,
my bad.
Man. Get out. That's what I thought. You see this TV? How big is this TV? You don't know how big it is, because it's big. And we do big things. A party game for horrible people. I'm a horrible person. You know why? I'm a drug dealer. I'm gonna take y'all to the sauce room. We call it sauce, you know what I'm saying? Sauce is code word for drugs. Is that Ron? Hey, yo, I think that's Ron. Yo, what's that noise coming from the weight room, man? Try some fuck tea, man.
For Jamal! For Jamal! For Jamal! Boss! So, you see me getting those games? I'm all here!
Yeah, you're getting a little big, I guess.
Yo, yeah, that's right, yeah. I'm gonna go get that protein, yo.
So why did you join the game?
You know, I love my job, and these guys, they're my friends. I gotta stick with them till the end. But Jamal, he's the real homie, you know? He can be rough on me sometimes, but I can take it, you know? Because I know that's just his way of showing that we real tight.
Your name's Rodell?
Yeah, yeah.
Didn't Jamal call you Ron in the weight room?
Oh, no. That's just a little inside joke, you know? Just don't worry about that. No.
Come on. Storage room. Hold up. I'm gonna introduce you to the new guy. You see this guy?
Oh, hi Jamal.
I forget your name, man. What's your name, man? I forgot you even live here, man. This is the basement. I don't even know you.
Yeah, this is where we do the spreadsheets.
Yeah. Okay, cut that, you know. Yeah. They want to see the new Bugatti. You know this new Bugatti? No keys. You know that one song, Lil Baby? Brand new whip, got no keys. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Hold up. Yeah.
So what got you here?
Oh, Stevie did. You know, he's been teaching me the spreadsheets recently, and I really look up to him.
Is he like a role model to you?
Yeah, for sure.
You dig? Hold up. It's the straps.
Say hello to my little friend.
I don't want to be down here too long, you know what I'm saying? I like being upstairs. Hey, yo! Ron, Stevie, come down here, man. Hurry up. Hurry. Chop. Hurry up. I got a hot deal for us. High risk, high reward. And we're dealing with the Surrey boys.
I'm here now.
Yo, out. You two now. Go. No, I'm not talking. Go. Leave. I'm not saying it again.
What do you mean?
Leave.
You called a meeting. My bad.
As I was saying.
The Surrey Jacks?
Yep.
Man, I don't know. I heard some sketchy stuff about the way that they do.
It's all gonna be good.
Man, I think if Jamal thinks we should take the deal, I think we should take it.
Nah,
like,
there's something fishy
we're
here.
Taking
there's
it,
no
Rodell.
Way. There's no way that they need product now. If they did, they would have asked for it years ago. It's way too much risk. Why are we doing this now?
Because I know it's gonna be a good deal.
No, man, you don't know what you're talking about. Stick to counting your bills.
Dude,
bro, man, you have right. No street smarts.
Dude, fine,
out, man.
Fine,
you don't know
fine.
The streets.
I'll go. I'll be here if you need
leave.
Me. Dude, come on, man.
Yeah. Are you serious?
Jamal just wants to kick me out because I'm not a part of the main squad? Like, there's only like 5 people in this gang. What does that even mean?
So how do you feel about that decision-making process?
I mean, it's tiring. You know, I'm kind of done. Every time I try to do anything intelligent, Rodel opens his mouth and his stupid monkey brain comes up with some kind of retort that helps Jamal.
Yeah, exactly.
And you know, it's always Jamal. Jamal always gets his way. Even if he makes a bad decision, Nobody can ever get anything done here. It's always him because Rodel's just there doing whatever he can to appease him.
How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel helpless, you know? I can't do anything. I can't do anything.
I thought I was called down there. Apparently I wasn't, but he didn't have to be rude about it. I don't understand that. I cooked the food for them. You know, they call my cooking bad. Sure, I cook badly, but it's not my fault they buy terrible ingredients. Like, come on. Stevie! How come he can be down there and not me? All he does is look at his computer and numbers all day. I feed them!
Yo, boss. Surrey Jacks offered us a good deal, a lot of money. What are we gonna do without our accountant, man?
Yeah. I think I could run the numbers myself. Yo. We need help.
We need Stevie.
Stevie, man. We need to talk. I need the whole gang in on this.
I've been talking, but you guys have to start listening to me.
Well, what you trying to say, man?
I'm trying to say it's too much risk. We've worked too long, too hard to give it away for some deal.
There's no risk. As long as we have no problem with them, they have no issue with us. Plus, I looked at the numbers. It's not so bad.
It's too risky.
Man, no risk, no reward. It's just a simple text message at the end of the day. There's no harm in that, is there?
I guess not.
Think about the PS4 we can get. You don't want to play any more PS3.
Is that worth dying for? Some video game?
Can you die through a text message? A text message never hurt anyone.
Yeah, man.
So what do you say, Steve? You'll run the numbers for us?
I guess so. But I don't like it.
Come on. You're my favorite anyway.
Alright. I'll run.
How do you feel that Jamal called Stevie his favorite?
Man, honestly, that was whack. Like, I do everything for him. Jamal and me are best buds. I feel like he just told Stevie that so that it would convince him for the deal. You know, Stevie, he's a wuss like that.
This is what we stand to gain.
Let's go. Did you know that Stevie was going to eventually agree to the deal?
Of course. I got this little trick on my sleeve. You know what I'm saying? I've been doing a little thing. And eventually the little big thing for me.
So you tricked him?
Essentially, yes.
How do you feel about manipulating one of your friends?
It's nothing to me. They're like dogs on a leash. What's up, doggy? What's up?
So guys, Mo Bamba is sicko mode.
So how do you guys feel about the deal? Are you nervous?
There's nothing to worry about, I think. Jamal said everything would be fine. What's the worst that could happen?
I mean, we could die. Jamal doesn't know everything, you know.
Actually, I do know everything, and there's nothing to worry about the deal.
Thank you.
Well, me, you know, I have faith in my boss. I trust him. Stevie, he's not like that. He's just a wuss.
That Stevie guy better put some trust into our gang. I trust my shooters and the people I deal with.
In truth, the deal isn't well organized and not well thought out either. They're always like this. It worries me not being, you know, in control of it in any way. Jamal's impulses could kill us. We could be dead by the end of today.
Good, Chief. You got the stuff?
You got the bag?
Bet.
Bet.
So we agreed on 4 keys, right?
Yeah, for 2K.
No, we said 2.5.
Actually, it was 3 keys and it was 6K, but...
I then show me the product.
Hey, yo, Bet. Rodell, let me see the stuff.
Aight.
Bro, this ain't enough for 2.5K.
I just got from El Patel last week. It's the best in the city, what
for
you
real?
Know?
This isn't reality. This is not reality.
Stop!
You violated the law. You're the fire.
To be honest, I didn't like that guy anyway.
That guy just killed his own guy!
You just killed that guy!
Doesn't matter, he killed his own guy!
Yo man, that was honestly crazy. Like, at first when I saw the first gunshot, my heart started racing and my stomach felt really weird. I just went and hid behind cover as a sign of fear.
What about you?
Well, it took some time for me. I heard the gunshots, dropped out of reflex, but once I was down, I couldn't decide if I was more scared or angry at these two for bringing me out here.
I'll give you the answer though. I'm pissed.
Well, since nobody's asking me, I was scared, but I knew how to react to these sort of situations, you know? I just dropped down, and whenever something's about to pop off, I'm ready.
Alright boys, I guess that's it for this MTV Cribs episode. You know what I'm saying? You know how I do and stuff. You know, I hope it wasn't too hectic. I mean, that's just a day in the life of Jamal, right? But hold up. I got one question. Where's the bay?
This is an analytical documentary. You guys volunteered for us to come here.
Hey! No bay, dog?